After much anticipation and patience, SpaceX has officially released an exciting update on Flight 7. The compilation of upgrades is packed with substantial improvements, many of which have exceeded all expectations, including my own. But that's just the beginning. SpaceX kicked off this year with a triumphant Falcon 9 mission. Given the many important developments coming out of the company, time is of the essence. Let's talk more on today's episode of NR Studio. We stand on the cusp of an exciting milestone. Flight 7 marks the inaugural Starship mission of 2025. This year marks a year of incredible accomplishments and innovations that will further expand the boundaries of space exploration. The Starship program is progressing at an impressive pace, and as Flight 7 approaches, it's important to take stock of what's been accomplished to date and what's to come. SpaceX is currently hard at work testing and optimizing various Starship components. These phases have successfully completed their respective assessments, and the next phase involves progress toward final integration. The successful transfer of the B1 booster to the launch pad is a major milestone in preparation for the mission. In a recent development, SpaceX announced that the Flight Termination System, FTS, was successfully integrated into the B1 booster on the evening of January 2nd, marking significant progress in the safety protocols for the upcoming flight. The B1 will remain in place, ready for the arrival of Starship S-33, at which time stacking and integration procedures will begin. As the various preparations culminate, SpaceX continues to advance toward its next critical goal, Flight 7. To ensure all parties remain well informed, updates regarding the Flight 7 NOTAMs, or notices to airmen, have been disseminated. These NOTAMs delineate the designated warning areas along with the precise timing of the flight, thereby affirming that all operations are proceeding as scheduled. Furthermore, SpaceX has offered updates regarding the timetable and geographical maps for the observation aircraft, which will play a pivotal role in monitoring the flight from afar. As these updates arrive, it becomes increasingly apparent that SpaceX is meticulously gearing up for an exhilarating launch. Indeed, following these encouraging updates, SpaceX has officially unveiled additional details regarding Flight 7, and the anticipation is unmistakable. The company announced on social media via a tweet that the sixth flight test of Starships is intended to explore the vehicle's boundaries as we advance towards a swiftly reusable rocket. Subsequently, we shall embark on a new vessel, embrace the forthcoming year, and redefine our boundaries. Enthusiasm remains unequivocally assured. This tweet accentuates the palpable excitement surrounding the impending advancements and technological breakthroughs. Musk himself highlighted the significance of these technical enhancements, noting that sharing updates on Starship's advancements is valuable, as many individuals appreciate grasping the progression of technology from one flight to the next. Musk's remarks underscore the company's dedication to transparency and its resolve to keep the public apprised while advancing towards a fully reusable rocket system. Feel free to explore these intriguing details. SpaceX has officially announced that Flight 7 will showcase the inaugural launch of Starship V2, representing a new generation of the spacecraft, equipped with numerous noteworthy enhancements. One of the most significant advancements is the implementation of innovative systems designed to enhance the reliability and performance of Starship's upper stage. SpaceX elucidated that the enhancements encompass adjustments to the four-flap system, which will now feature reduced dimensions and more acute edges. The flaps will be relocated nearer to the tip of the vehicle while being positioned further away from the heat shield. This modification aims to enhance the contribution of the four-flap system to navigational efficacy while simultaneously offering improved protection during the re-entry phase. A pivotal update pertains to the propulsion system. The one-flap ship V2 is set to incorporate a 25% augmentation in fuel capacity, enabling extended mission duration. To facilitate this enhancement, the vehicle will also undergo refinements in its fuel feed line system, which delivers fuel to the Raptor vacuum engines. Moreover, SpaceX plans to adopt vacuum jacketing for the feed lines and enhance the propulsion avionics module that regulates the vehicle's valves and sensors. Regarding the heat shield, a central topic in earlier Starship updates, the forthcoming iteration will feature advanced tiles that provide superior protection. These tiles will be complemented by an additional backup layer to safeguard against potential gaps where tiles may be absent or compromised, thereby enhancing the spacecraft's resilience during re-entry. In parallel, avionics, an essential component of the vehicle's flight control system, will receive significant enhancements. The revamped avionics system will feature enhanced flight computers, integrated antennas that amalgamate Starlink, GNSS, and supplementary RF communication capabilities, along with upgraded inertial navigation and star tracking sensors. Furthermore, the system will incorporate intelligent batteries and power units, delivering an impressive 2.7 megawatts of power across two high-voltage actuators. In excess of 30 cameras will be integrated into the vehicle to surveil hardware performance throughout the flight, providing engineers with real-time insights that facilitate swift adjustments and enhancements. In the context of Starlink, the satellite internet system is poised to play a pivotal role in the forthcoming flight. As emphasized by SpaceX, the Starship will possess the capability to stream over 120 megabits per second of high-definition video and telemetry during the mission. This capability will enable both engineers and observers to monitor the spacecraft's journey with unprecedented precision. As Starlink's capabilities advance, it becomes evident that the system will be instrumental in the success of forthcoming missions. Let us now delve into the particulars of the mission itself. Flight 7 is set to transport payloads, signifying the inaugural occasion on which Starship will execute payload deployment in the expanse of space. SpaceX has officially announced the deployment of 10 Starlink simulators aboard the spacecraft. Engineered to replicate the dimensions and weight of the forthcoming generation of Starlink satellites, this payload deployment is slated to occur during a suborbital trajectory, thereby yielding critical data and enhancing the operational capacities of Starship. Furthermore, SpaceX intends to reignite one of the Raptor engines in the vacuum of space, which serves as a pivotal test to showcase the spacecraft's capability to execute intricate maneuvers while in orbit. Upon the completion of the mission, the strategy entails executing a regulated vertical landing in the Indian Ocean during the second stage. This landing is a vital component of the continual advancement of the spacecraft's reusability, which will play an essential role in ensuring the program's long-term success. I must highlight that one of the most thrilling facets of this flight is the array of tests that will be undertaken in preparation for the eventual capture of the second stage in future missions, likely commencing with Flight 8. In preparation for upcoming missions, SpaceX has strategically removed select tiles to conduct stress tests on specific regions of the spacecraft, particularly those susceptible to vulnerabilities during reentry. This undertaking involves the implementation of an innovative metallic tile in conjunction with an active cooling system, which will undergo testing during this flight to assess its effectiveness in safeguarding the Starship throughout reentry. Thermal systems will be strategically installed on both sides of the vessel to effectively address any potential issues associated with heat accumulation. A radar sensor is also set to undergo testing within the chopstick system, designed to enhance the precision of distance measurements between the vehicle and the catching mechanism. This enhancement is crucial for augmenting the likelihood of a successful Starship recovery in forthcoming missions, and it signifies a noteworthy advance in the evolution of reusable space transportation systems. Moreover, the Super Heavy booster, essential to this mission, will incorporate an engine from the B-12 Flight 5 booster, probably Raptor 31, thereby achieving a significant milestone in Starship's reusability initiative. This remarkable advancement underscores SpaceX's dedication to reusability and the pursuit of cost-effective solutions in space travel. Regarding the tower hardware, it will undergo enhancements to enhance its resilience against the forces of the launch process, thereby ensuring the catch system's integrity and functionality are maintained. In the event of an emergency or an unsuccessful recovery attempt, SpaceX has devised a contingency landing strategy in the Gulf of Mexico, emphasizing the paramount importance of safety. The company recognized the considerable noise impact generated by the flight, yet underscored that it is an integral component of the refinement process for Starship in upcoming missions. Beyond these considerations, SpaceX aspires to attain complete reusability, with intentions to transport both humans and cargo to orbit the Moon and Mars. As previously mentioned, this upcoming year promises to be a pivotal one for Starship, with aims to operationalize the full reusability of the system while undertaking progressively more ambitious missions. Flight 7 represents a pivotal advancement in the quest to enhance the sustainability and accessibility of space travel. Should you share my enthusiasm for this mission, kindly respond with "I'm ready" in the comments below, and remember to like and subscribe for further updates. There is no doubt in my keen eye that this year will be a transformative one for SpaceX, as they kicked off 2025 with a remarkable Falcon 9 mission. Notably, at 8:27 p.m. Eastern Time on January 3rd, SpaceX successfully launched a Falcon 9 rocket from SLC-0 in Florida. The rocket successfully carried the Thuria spacecraft into geostationary orbit, AGSO, marking a major milestone for the company and the satellite payload from Thuria, a leading satellite communication service provider in the UAE. The mission's booster, named B-1073, successfully landed on the ASOG drone ship after a nearly 9-minute ascent, marking its 20th successful landing. As a result, SpaceX's total number of successful landings has increased to 31 so far. Following the booster landing, the payload was successfully launched into orbit about 35 minutes later, underscoring the precision and reliability of SpaceX's rocket technology. This is SpaceX's 18th Falcon 9 mission and 35th overall, launching from SLC-0, accounting for nearly two-thirds of Falcon 9 launches in 202. The launch pad has recorded a total of 62 launches, most notably featuring the rapid rotation of the B-1080 booster, and is poised to maintain its significance throughout 2025 alongside other operational pads. As the inaugural Falcon 9 mission of 2025, this launch marks the start of a busy year ahead, with over 180 Falcon 9 launches and 25 Starship launches projected. After reaching an incredible milestone in 202 with 138 missions, SpaceX is now poised for rapid progress, building momentum as it approaches Flight 7. Anticipation for the upcoming missions is building, laying the foundation for unprecedented progress throughout the year. That's it for today's episode. See you next time.